Hello and welcome to Sunless Sunday. As always, my name is Zara, and it's me, Modine. There's a reference for you. So yes, it is Sunday. It is time for more Sunless Skies, which I am greatly looking forward to. I love this game. It's a lot of fun. But it is... it's definitely a slow burner, to say the least. We've got a lot of work to do. We've got a lot of stuff to find. But we've got... we got lots of time to do it, so I'm not too worried. What else was there? I feel like there was something else I needed to talk about, but I can't remember what it was, so... I guess I will... just... get things moving right along. Oh, and I'll have the game crash on me while I try to run it. That's a good start. Come on, Sunless guys. Don't do this to me. I need you. Doesn't like it when you alt-tab while it's trying to load. Alright, so... what happened last time? Jeez, I don't even remember. I know we did a bunch of, like, deliveries. Kind of back and forth. I'm gonna turn down the music just a tad. So last time we left off here in Titania, which is a giant orchid that has a city built within it. There's not really much to do here right now. Things will open up later once we come back. But let's see what else we have to do. So we are currently looking for... we are trying to find the identity of the owner of Magdalene. So far we haven't really found anything concrete. We have the daughter of Queen Victoria on our ship. She's part of our crew. We also have an incautious driver. And as always, we've got the black box left behind from Captain Whitlock, who died at the beginning of our journey. So there's a few things that we're doing. We're looking for Hesperidian cider. We need to find... this is kind of the one that we're looking for right now, Bronzewood. Because we can get that at Traitor's Wood. But I don't know where Traitor's Wood is. We've explored a sizable chunk of the Reach around New Winchester, but we still don't know where Traitor's Wood is, and there's definitely other places in here for us to find. Oh, and we found a circus last time. I think last time we also... oh, we picked up an inadvisedly big dog as part of our crew members. He's huge. He's a good dog. And then we also hired on the Rat Brigade, I think toward the end of last stream. They are our chief engineers at the moment. We'll talk to them a little later. For now, we're good on fuel and supplies. Let's keep exploring. Let's head out into the great green yonder and see what we can find. We also picked up a canning upgrade for our train, our locomotive, that I have not been able to use once yet. Ooh, that's not good. Is this in, like, its own little pocket here? Yeah, it looks like it is. guess we're taking the long way around. What is this? Do I need to drill for this too? Yep, I do. Son of a pea. Take my rage out on this marauder. That right there is skill. Marauders are rarely democratic. Captain rules by strength and claims the best for their own keep. Let's do it. What was that? Oh, 100% of success. Alright. Yeah, we've had this one before. We blow open the doors and kill the captain. And we get some documents. And so we've got two salons to gossip. We've got four now. It's always good to have gossip. Gossip is a good resource. Comes up pretty often. Same with the secrets. Ah yes, the Williams wheel. Let's see what my scout finds, if anything. Run wild. Peacock wind buffets the engine, and cautious driver whistles a jolly tune. And our bat has found something. I don't know if we can actually get down here because of the wind. Terror in the hull. 53% chance. Oh, that's right. We're dangerously low on crew now, too. I think that's what I was going to New Winchester for. Okay. Surprisingly hurried. They retrieve only handfuls of valuables before the hull's groans and crew then we return your vessel. We lost two crew, gained a tale of terror, gained 72 bucks. Well, that's not bad. Oh boy. I think I'm gonna try going around. Chance to read that message about my food stores. That's it. Sure. Stupid wind. We're still pretty good on hull. Let's loot the hold. A solid crate. What could be in this crate? It is the final product of London's greatest and most precious enterprise. We got a barrel of unseasoned hours. Which... I feel like I needed those somewhere. Oh yeah, we have a filmmaker on board from No, we have to go to Hybris to find the filmmaker and bring them back to New Winchester. That's what that quest is. But we haven't found Hybris yet. And we also have a settler going to Traitor's Wood. I felt like there was some sort of quest where we needed unseasoned hours for, and we had some, but not quite enough. But I don't remember what it was. Let's see what my scout finds. We're dangerously low on crew right now. That's not good. I guess we'll go back to New Winchester and hire on some proper crew. There's one place I know I can definitely do that. Pages of the Gazette are awash with scandal, skullduggery at Port Avon. The pages of the Gazette are awash with scandal. The Port Avon Parish Council complains of noises from the local ruins at night. The prudent secretary is eager for any confirmation of tackety activity in the ruins. The injured veteran would also like someone to look into the matter, though not too hard mind. Investigate rumors. What could anyone want with some old moldering stones? The Gazette has little of concrete use. Rumors of this or that criminal spied in ruins, a particularly lurid theory about sacrificing company officials to unmentionable powers. If you want to find out what's really going on, we'll have to go to Port Ava. Alright, so let's go to Victory Hall. We can deliver our port reports to the injured veteran. I believe we only had two of them. Yeah, so we got 200 bucks, some more fortune. What can we trade favor to affect the balance of the power in reach? We are becoming more powerful. Trade for another worldly artifact. We'll wait on the rest of the stuff for now. So right now I need to go spend all of our money on repairs and crew members down in New Winchester. Old Sea Station. Okay, let's hire crew. Hire many crew for 80 bucks. Six crew. Brings us back up to 8. Perfect. I guess we could also repair. $30 or 30. I guess we might as well just spend 39. Spend $9 extra dollars, or sovereigns, excuse me, to fully repair our hull. Critical damage quality is gone. I didn't know we had that. What else can we do here? There's all kinds of shops. I guess more than anything. We need to resupply. Boy, my hold is kind of full of junk here, isn't it? What do we have here? Okay, yeah, we did need hours for the lead beater and stain rod nature reserve. I don't even know where that is. And munitions for Port Prosper. Port Prosper is way on the other side of the map. Oof. I guess we don't need the caddy of dried tea. Or the caged catch. I suppose I could sell the caged catch for another 200 bucks. And the dried tea. We don't have a lot of room in our hold, unfortunately. And then I'll get... a bunch of fuel and supplies. And let's head on over to Abraham's Engineering. See what else we get. Actually got enough money that we might be able to get some sort of upgrade here. We'd get more men. Could also get a new weapon. Long range, fast firing, self-cooling armament for the captain who likes things settled promptly. Barrel revolves, possibly powered by spite. I think that's like a rapid fire gun, which I'm not sure I'm not entirely convinced that we want that one just yet. Kind of want to get the mining array because we've found things that actually use it that much. I guess this is just another kind of shell like what we've got already. Damage 15, so it does a little bit more damage. Something like that might actually be worth buying. But I'm gonna hold off. Because you never know what we might find out here. What we need all of our money for. And I wouldn't mind saving up for another new locomotive as well. Get some more cargo space. Oh. I was looking at my terror, I wasn't paying attention where I was going. Head over to Port Avon and see if we can do that mission that they were talking about, Victory Hall. Now that I've actually got our crewmates equipped properly, we might be able to roll a little bit better on our skill checks. There's something down here. Supplies. Hey. It's always nice getting free supplies because they're kind of expensive. A So Port Prosper is the place where you need to have their favor in order to do stuff around town. They grow apples. Unlike the scent of apples. So hopefully we have been gone long enough to have gotten some favor back. Quiet day in Port Haven. There's also the repentant devil here. Do we have a signaler? We do. We've got the amiable vagabond. Picked him up from the circus. Iron by two, bales by six in your affiliation academy. Plus four hearts, plus four bales, and affiliation bohemia. Maybe not yet. Buy cheap fuel at the engine yard. This will give you two fuel for 20 sovereigns. Oh wow, that's a steal of a deal. But I don't need any now. That's how it always happens. Not worth it. Alright, Port Avon spills prettily across sections of colossal drifting ruins. But the money you could have saved. I know. Share exotic gossip with the locals. Our Port Avon welcome is now two. You make for the Nowhere, the local pub, where you can be sure of an audience, ears bent to overhear your conversation about a London scandal. One resident even buys you a drink, an unquestionable honor. Let's write a port report. Were it not for talk of smugglers and sky beasts, you could easily confuse this place for a village on the world you left behind. Quite peaceful here, apart from some fuss over a newspaper delivery. The villagers frown and change the subject when you ask about it. Okay, so the rumors that we heard are coming from the ruins. We were here once already. We failed a skill check, so let's go check things out. What purpose did they serve in the past? Plentiful days when their sun still shone. The finest cathedrals of old France. Huh. I'm curious to know what, like, the normal world is like in the Fallen London universe. Because I know in Sunless Seas you could actually get there. You could actually, there's a way to get back to the surface. And it was, you could get some stuff from the surface that was like super profitable, but it also took a ton of supplies to get there. I guess we are here to, investigate the rumors of Tackety Men ruins. That's the one. Tackety Men have been seen entering the ruins in the dead of night, armed with shovels and lanterns. Hey, what's going on? You wait until the sky is dark and the distant stars have dimmed before making your way to the ruins. You go alone, bearing only a shuttered lantern. Dust rises underfoot as you tread along shadowed halls, greater and gloomier than the manors of old London, through gaps between stones, narrower than the inside of a coffin. Voices grow near. Voices in a rich, resplendent light. The luminous glow of brilliant souls mined from the ruins infects this hidden habitation with radiance. A group of heavy-set men and women in hobnail boots are just ahead. They are intent not on the deposits of souls, but on the hollows amidst the stones, where they are busy burying caches of munitions. A crunch of stone behind you, a beam of lantern light. The burly MacDonald brothers have followed you in. Warn the Tacketies. If they're discovered, they'll be booted off Port Avon, or assist the MacDonalds. Tacketies engage in unauthorized mining of ours? No good can come from it. Well, we have been kind of working with the Tacketies so far, so it seems only right that we warn them. You rush into the breach, startling the illegal miners. A chorus of surprise and alarm greets your sudden entrance, but there's no time for questions. You convince the leader, a hard-bitten ex-prospector, to lead her men out through an alternate escape route blasted into the ruins. You cut an expensive deal and stay behind to tell the McDonald's you were on a nighttime stroll when you stumbled on a cave-in. They're more than happy to believe in the stupidity of outsiders. The Tacketies will be back for their weapons in the future, but next time, they'll be more careful about it. Alright, so we helped the Tacketies, got $100, up to 771, gained 10 fortune with the Tacketies, gained 10 reputation with them. Wearing out our welcome, we lost fortune with the stovepipes, and we gained experience. Cool. What else is there to do? I mean, we still have Welcome in Port Avon. Watch a cricket match? I don't understand cricket. Let's go back to the roots. There's still things we could do here. Conduct a nocturnal investigation. 46%, 50%. Enjoy the picturesque surroundings. How they soar, how tragic, how solemn. Like the most rampant visions of Turner. Hey. How vast were the beings that resided here? Were they kings? Was this their palace? You sit in the monumental shadow of a stone and watch the stars wheel above. What they must think, those stars, to see such grand ruins become the abode of such tiny, brief things. Alright. We are no longer welcome in Port Avon. McDonald boys are watching the ruins, crunchings in hand. Best keep out. Dangerous place. Fair enough. We could spend some more of our gossip to increase our welcome again, but I think we've done all that we need to do here in Port Avon for now. Did we complete? Okay, we did complete that mission, so we don't need to follow up with anything else. I suppose in the meantime, maybe I'll head south from here and kind of like loop up and around if need be. Cut that one a little close. Hey, Traitor's Wood. We found it. But where's the port? Where can we go to dock? Is it down here? Doesn't seem promising. Oh, it's always one of those moments that I hate where it's like, you can keep pressing on, but if you get to that point where you don't have enough supplies or fuel to get back, you know, you reach that point of no return where you still got enough to get back, so do you turn back and you press on and continue exploring. The looming bronze woods cast deep shadows, perfect hiding places for outcasts, killers, and the desperate. Oh boy. Yeah, shoot each other. This is like a marauder base. I guess that would explain the name Traitor's Wood. Yeah. inadvisedly big dog whines pitiably, affected by the dread that permeates your engine. Aww. Sorry, buddy. I'm kind of in the middle of something right now. Okay, so that's one down. Let's loot the hold. Precious has been concealed in this clasped jewelry box. It's a sheaf of letters. Falls from a concealed compartment. Pages are rife with scandal. Yes. Oh. I always... the safe for money or explore the captain's cabin for unusual items. I mean, we do have like 700 bucks, but we're pretty good on money. So let's see if we can find some weird stuff. No, this is the same one we got before. We got more gossip. Okay. Let's get the supplies. Oh, repaired my hull. Now let's talk to our dog. Who's a good dog? Okay. I guess he was just whining because of some reason, but... I don't think I want to be here. This is a marauder hideout. I don't want to waste a bunch of fuel and supplies fighting more of them, so... just get on up out of here. Back into the bronze wood. Morale is strained and someone has been careless. One of the barrels in your hold wasn't securely fastened. It has split, spilling the precarious hours across the floor. Oh no. Already the hour's insistent melancholy has begun to permeate the engine and your clocks are becoming erratic. Throw out the whole barrel full. Some of the geodes are cracked. The safest thing is to dispose of them quickly and don't miss that any spilled out. Or order the crew to collect every single hour. It will expose them to the stray solemn hours unspooling in the hold. Waste not want. Our engine is entirely crewed by the living. It sure is. We can make do without. I feel like if I did the other one, I'd probably have crew die on me, and I don't want that. Got it. Oh, that's not good. I don't know what that is. Oh my god. Jeez. Okay. I don't want to fight this thing. Let's get out of here. Let me loot. Search for survivors. We don't need crew. Loot the hold. A distressingly odored barrel. No one is keen to get close. Ugh. You pry the lid off. Dear God, what the blazes? Your navigator pokes the thing inside with a big stick until assured that it is dead. We have an uncanny specimen. And hey, we leveled up. So we are level 5. We've got some new moments of reflection that we can take. A settler, the blockade of New Winchester, a coterie, a thief oath, a metamorphosis. Worst things happen at Z. Haunted. So I guess, was that a bad squid? I don't know what that was. I think it might have been some sort of ghost thing. I've encountered one before, but I think that's like a more powerful one. I don't really want to mess with it. So what stat are we looking to increase? I would say... increasing our mirrors might be a good idea. A spell in prison. A settler. For a time, you lived the hand-to-mouth existence of a homesteader, carving a home on the frontier of the Reach. A hard scrabble existence, scratched from the sky a month at a time. The Reach is verdant, but its homesteads cling to tiny, exposed sky rocks. Most fail. In the end, to what drove you back to the skies. Predators or one bad season. The merciless tides of the Winchester War. You fought as long as you could. Yeah, toughness. 40 iron, 31 mirrors. Okay, let's see if we can kind of like skirt around this thing. If it goes away far enough, then it'll like de-aggro. God, I'm gonna swap out for the drill. Screw this canning thing. It's not doing any good for us. Kind of getting to the edge of the reach, so there's going to be more powerful help. I want to fight you. In the heart of the wood, silent and solemn. The Regent's Grave. Here, at the heart of the forest, a great barrow built from ancient stone stands. Gates of star-forged bronze block the entrance. Something is whispering from the other side. Force open the gate. The gates will not budge. The metal scrapes and screams against the rock, and your arms strain with the effort, but the gate holds fast. The whispering increases in volume from the darkness, but fades away as it becomes apparent you won't succeed. Inlaid in the middle of the gate are three hollows, the shape of seals. You can see no sign of any such object nearby. Perhaps the station at Traitor's Wood might be a starting point. Yeah, it sure would, but I don't know where it is. You leave the long dark of the barrel behind. Okay, terror is getting a little high. The Regent's Grave is a horror on the world map here, so being around it increases our terror faster. So we don't want to spend too much time there. Oh, that's a dead end. Oh no, your last battle resulted in a number of injuries among your crew. Medical bay is crowded. The prognosis are not good. Plunder your supplies for medicine, whatever the patients need. Ooh boy. 53% chance of success. I'm a surgeon. It's touch and go, but all your patients will make satisfactory recoveries. 1,000 deaths wait in the sky, but today, you thwarted them all. Rumors of mutiny. A pistol has vanished from the armory. Knives are disappearing. The signs of insurrection. I just saved your guys' lives. Rude. That's not gonna work. What will come will come. Lower our terror by 50, but increase our nightmares. Well, we haven't had to deal with any nightmares yet, so seems like as good a time as any. You do not punish your crew or turn one against another. They know you know of their schemes and find your eerie calm unsettling. The mutinous incidents cease for now. Have the mutineers changed their mind, or are they biding their time? Is there a pistol under a pillow waiting for a chance to end you? Our terror has fallen, but our nightmares are now at level 1. Disquieting. A bump in the night. Midnight, London time. You are alone on the bridge. While consulting your chart, a loud thump makes you look up. A frozen corpse is pressed against your forward windows, trapped there by your speed. The winds must have plucked it from some loft wreck and carried it into your path. The corpse's glare is insistent. Its mustache is bristled with frost. Try to shake the corpse off by employing a series of drastic maneuvers. Don't worry, guys, I got this. A sudden break. A cant to starboard. With the squeal of flesh on glass, the body slides from the windows and is lost into view. A scrap of its sleeve remains caught on a rivet, flapping like a tiny celebratory flag. You are not alone. I'm sure it'll be fine. Oh no. Please go. Please. I don't want to fight you. Oh dear. Extremely bad. They're faster than me. But I think if I get far enough, they'll de-aggro. As long as I stay at long range, then they can't really hit me with their big attack. They hit me with that one, though. Alright. Might be the end of us. Uh-oh. Yep. That's it. With a groan like a dying whale, your locomotive's hull buckles. Your hull has fallen to zero. Your captain is dead. The cold takes us. That's it. Oh, and I didn't even put anything in the vault that we had, so we don't even get to keep anything. Alright, so let's see. Not all is lost. They managed to reclaim the Orphean. Spatchcock reclaimed locomotive. Though most of its fixtures were reclaimed, the Murgatroyd's staying away canning station was unfortunately lost. I never liked that thing anyway. Convention did not dictate your predecessor's life. Your fellow Bohemians collaborated to provide this gift in their memory. So we got two visions of the heavens, two savage secrets, and a tale of terror. Okay. An honest gift or stolen goods. Your predecessor's villainous affiliations have profited you well. Got almost 400 bucks. A partial chart. I will start at level 4. The bank, after funeral expenses, had passed on what was left. Though possibly inaccurate, a copy of your predecessor's chart was discovered, and when all is done, you will be a wiser person than the previous captain started out as. Welp. So, I mean, really, we didn't lose that much. But now we get to make a new captain. So our previous captain was a Zaler from the Unterzee. Maybe this one should be someone less less punch happy. Perhaps a poet. Or an academic. Ministry auditor. I like the idea of being a poet. Poetry was popular in the old London. Some poets sought fame, others art. Some simply enjoyed bohemian company. Three preeminent artistic movements have come to prominence. The Celestials. In old London, they wrote nostalgically of the surface and the sun. Now they write of the stars and the treasures of heaven. The Nocturnals, a radical outlawed school that delights in freedoms found in the dark. Or the Sovereign School, a new tradition born in the Empress's court. Their works are patriotic, bombastic, and occupied with the iconography of time, clocks and seasons and sand and so forth. All right, so we're gonna have high heart. We are a bleeding heart poet. What other stat should we have high? I'm thinking mirrors. We are a very observant and well-intentioned poet. The Celestials. What does winning mean to you? It seems, last time we did well, so, and it seems only appropriate that a poet would be looking for fame. So let's do it. We'll try to immortalize our exploits in the Song of the Sky. Let's randomize this avatar until we get something good. Ooh, very powerful. That looks pretty good. I like the look of that. What would our, I guess let's randomize our name here. Nurse Boyle, Sister Murphy, Citizen Bell, Professor O'Connor, Professor Wu. Sir Williams, Madame Griffiths. Reverend Harrison, Officer Gunn. Let's go. Principal Baby, Comrade Abernathy. That's a good name, but probably not for this character. Specialist Moy. Administrator Lewis, Madame Irwin. I like that one. Madame Irwin. Kind of a weird way to spell Irwin, but yeah, I like it. The poet, Madame Irwin. Looking for fame out here in the Reach. Alright, so we start at level 4, so we've got a whole bunch of reflections to choose from. An esteemed predecessor. Ah, so this moment of reflection is unlocked because we had another captain who preceded us. An earlier captain in your lineage is held in high regard. Some of your predecessors' shine rubbed off on you. It opened doors. Expensive doors with bright brass knockers and servants to answer them. Where did those doors lead? To the parlors of privileged, to the halls of academia. We did get this lizard last time, because it is an extremely good lizard. But we are a poet this time. It only makes sense that we were the gossip of London salons. Mad, they said. Bad, they said. Dangerous to know. What was the incident that exposed you to the buffeting winds of public opinion? A torrid affair? Or parade of debauchery? I like the torrid affair. Secret letters, warm and yearning. Furtive fascinations, where desires, among other things, could be unlaced. The reports were salacious. What else do we got here? A disgraced predecessor. Tarred with your predecessor's brush, many doors were closed to you. Where did you turn to find acceptance? To romantics. The tale of your predecessor appealed to them. Misunderstood, they said. Ahead of their time, they said. Tragic, they said. Yeah, I like that one. And what else? Let's say either veils or mirrors should be the main thing. I want it, a promise of days. A coterie. Along with some dear friends and acquaintances, you have formed a tightly bound clique of free spirits. Finding the prevailing opinions of society stifling, you sought solace among your congenial company. What shared interest brought you together? Oh, this will reduce my nightmares, so I think I'll hold off on that one. That might be useful later on. 15 minutes of fame. One of your works propelled you to brief sudden fame. You heard that even the captivating princess said something offhand complimentary about it at a salon. Gushing articles in the Gazette, breathless flattery in the salons, you were showered with attention and gifts. You had admirers. How did you take to fame? I've withered and fled. Fame was never the goal. Celebrity only interfered with your work. You became a recluse, spurning the invitations and ignoring the doorbell. Yeah, but we want fame. We want fame, so that doesn't seem quite right. The August Avenues. You spent your youth in stuffy sitting rooms and chandeliered parlors. Hush, you can still hear their delicate sound of silver spoons on china cups. You were not ungrateful, but your life was hedged by bounds of civility and expectations. You had to disobey sometimes to discover who you were. When you had to rebel, how did you do it? Secretly and occasionally. You wouldn't bring shame to your household. You kept your disobediences modest and discreet. No one was any the wiser. All right, so that's a pretty good start. We are extremely weak. But we are very honest and fairly observant, as well as being a little bit devious. All right, so in order to become famous, we need to write the song of the sky. So we take advantage of a quiet moment to pull out our journal. The blank page sits before you, smug and unblemished. The horror. At last, inspiration strikes. You need fresh material. That's the ticket. So if we gather sky stories and tales of terror, we can begin the song of the sky. Okay, it doesn't actually tell you what you need. Back in Sunless Seas, one of the ambitions you could do, or like one of the endgame conditions, it would actually list out all of the things that you needed. And there was like at least 10 different items, like, you know, songs of this, or like rumors and tales of terror and all those kind of things, and you needed a whole bunch of different ones. All right, so we're all full up on fuel supplies. We're pretty much ready to go. We still have the black box. That always comes back. We can recruit the incautious driver again. That only makes sense. We lost all of our items, basically. That kind of sucks, but such is the penalty of death. Okay, there's not much else to do here, so let's pick up the shops. $300. Mm-hmm. might be worth getting some armor next time. I was looking at the armor before we left on the last one, and it probably would have been smart to go that way. Oh well. What kind of prospects do we have? Seeds for Magdalens. Hours for the Lip Beater and Stainrod Nature Reserve. Let's do Seeds for Magdalens. And we still don't know where Leadbeater and Stainrod is, so I'm not going to bother doing that one yet. We are going to... I'm pretty sure if you die with one of these other locomotives, it gets inherited, because they are very expensive. And I didn't put anything in the storage, because I forgot about it. I should have done that last time. Oh well. I don't think we can afford anything else, so... Actually, just gonna fill up on a little bit more fuel and supplies. And... yeah, we can set out into the world again. So we've pretty much got... I guess we have all of the chart that we started the stream with, basically. So... we know that the Traitor's Wood is down here somewhere. I don't know where exactly, but it's like, I guess it was kind of down this way. But we don't have that section of our map filled out. As for our journal... okay, so we still know about the Albert Clock. And... okay. So, yeah, I think I'll just head down to Port Avon for now, and then we'll kind of see if we can find the Traitor's Wood. Is that... yeah, we'll go this way. And this time I'm buying that damn drill. Screw the canning equipment. Didn't do us any good. Hey, I got an achievement. The Fortunes of War. I have no idea what that means. Oh. Attack it ease. Well, I didn't expect to die so soon in the game, which is a little unfortunate. I left behind a lot of unfinished stories, but like I said, it's all kind of like a legacy game, so you can go back and redo pretty much any of the storylines. Avon's down here. The only downside is that now we have to actually go and redo them. To this guy before about the Hesperidian sucker, so we might as well get that quest back. That's in London, so that's actually a long ways off. Cyclopean ruins. 83% chance. Yeah, let's get a vision of the heavens. Partial success. Yep. piece is interrupted by a whistling, a popular tune, appallingly executed. A painter is here. He has set his back to a towering arch and is painting its reflection from a mirror set beside his easel. The mirror's glass is black, dulling the vibrant green of the moss and the scintillating hues of the sky. The truly picturesque requires a certain restraint, he explains, frowning irritably over his shoulder at the splendid view. This is a trying rather too hard, don't you think? His presence has ruined the atmosphere, but your walk is not unpleasant. Jerk. Let's get out of here. Port Avon continues to be a charming place. But we ain't got time for that. We're looking for Bronzewood. We will succeed where our predecessor failed. We will find the traitor's wood, or we will die. At least we get the experience for exploring it again. Where is the dock? There is definitely a port. Let's send our scout. It's probably the smart plan. I feel like that is the grave that we found last time. This may be a bad idea. Certainly going to run into more of those specters. Oh, wait. What is this? A new port captain, your crew crowd to the windows. It is the Summerson Camp. Traitor's Wood is a sprawling, secluded forest on the edge of the Reach. Few venture beneath its gloomy boughs, and legend speaks of a king who sleeps under the barrow at the wood's heart. Alright. So here at the bazaar, they indeed have Bronzewood. So I'm gonna buy one of them, because I'm pretty sure we just need the one. We need the Bronzewood and honey. And the honey, I'm pretty sure we can get from Magdalene's. Okay, so there's a few things to do here. Let's go to the wood's edge. The wood is as vast as a felt giant and fathomless as a great ocean. Like the ocean, much of it is hidden from view. Careful expeditions are required to go deeper into the wood. The forest is rich and wild in the verdant species of the Reach. Exploring the starlight-dappled edges of the wood could be profitable. You may only perform one of these actions a fortnight. Wood guards in secrets. I don't like those odds for any of these, so let's perhaps not do that. But three figures draped in scholars' robes huddled around a campfire. They're arguing about kings. A banner in the colors of Somerset, a London university's most respectable college, gleams in the firelight. As you approach, the discussion dies. One of the scholars, a woman with a fierce expression, stands up. Only scholars should be here. Are you one? No, I am not. Perhaps a gift would persuade them to let you enter the camp. They look wretched camped out here. No, I am not an academic, but I have supplies. The vituperative classicist compares you to offering with the burnt toast and wan tea that they have been suffering on. Well, all right, I suppose. The woman is a vituperative classicist. Her companions, a dismal paleographer, a forlorn young man, and a feckless theologian, a handsome young youth with an easy smile. They explain that they are here to enter the regent's grave, where they believe a sleeping king lies buried. They do not agree as to the king's identity. Unfortunately, the college has cut our funding, the classicist explains. Speak to us if you'd be interested in helping. The shadow of the barrow falls over the camp. A mournful wail carries on the wind. A cluster of scholars has set up camp on the border of the wood, their funding gone. They struggle to continue their research into whoever is entombed in the regent's grave. The wind howls into the trees, and the skies threaten rain. The scholars huddle in their tents, brooding over papers, conspiring against colleagues. Ask how we can help. Your inquiry induces a rare spirit of cooperation in the scholars. The last expedition into the woods found a document written in the correspondence. It contained directions to a place called the Steward's Font, the theologian explains. Alas, that is all that needs to be. That is all it needs to break their alliance. The paleographer begins to argue that the steward was a chief position in Charlemagne's household. The classicist makes a pointed reference to Inanna's husband. The theologian's smile is forced. If you could find the font, it would be an immense boon to my work. There's sputters of protestation. Our work. We can begin expeditions from the expedition to the deep wood. Okay. Let's speak to the feckless theologian. The divinity student has a dozen bad habits and a firm conviction that St. John the Apostle slumbers in the regent's grave. The theologian's tent is the largest of the three. Its interior has been decorated with carpets and throws, which trap the smoke from his hookah. The air is a scented fug. The theologian is reclining on cushions, drinking wine. Let's ask him about his theory. Why does he think St. John is buried in a forgotten tomb in the high wilderness? The theologian's eyes widen. He is delighted to have been asked that question. According to the legend Aurea, St. John is sleeping somewhere, waiting for the coming of the Antichrist, which would mean the end of the world. And what is the high wilderness but that? We left the world behind, and the stars are going out. And just after we arrive, we discover a tomb hidden in an ancient wood. He runs a hand through his hair. Sometimes we must have faith. What do you think about the dismal paleographer? The theologian smiles innocently. Yes, we used to know each other. Very well indeed. This was back at college, before all his passion got sucked out of him. He sighs. Some people can't accept change. What about the vituperative classicist? She's very talented and very funny, and not all that nice. And she's furious with me. Why? He won't say. I think I've done enough damage with both of them. He shakes his head. If it weren't for St. John and the Academic Senate sending me here, I doubt I'd have seen her again, until she became principal, of course. Okay. What about... Let's talk to the vituperative classicist. The student of the ancient world is armed with more scorn than a vengeful goddess and a firm conviction that the Sumerian Queen of Heaven sleeps in the regent's grave. Ooh boy. The classicist's tent is practical and largely unornamented. The interior is damp from her various walking clothes, which have been scattered across the floor. Old playbills and gaudy costume jewelry hang from the tent ceiling like charms. The classicist is pacing the tent, reading Herodotus while smoking up a storm. Alright, why do you believe the ancient Sumerian deity Inanna is buried in a forgotten tomb in the high wilderness? Isn't it obvious? She rolls her eyes. Fine, I'll tell you what I told the Academic Senate. The high wilderness is heaven, not as the Church conceives it, but as the Sumerians did. A place of stars and chaos and impossible powers. In proximity to and affecting our own world, but far, far removed. She pauses for breath. Inanna, Queen of Heaven, entered the underworld in search of her husband and was trapped for a time. That is the myth, and this may be the truth. She waves her hand dismissively. Besides, we made some promising discoveries in the wood. What do you think of the feckless theologian? Her invective goes on for an hour, and she only remembers to fetch you tea midway through. A liar and a traitor and a fool, she says, spooning in entirely too much sugar. I loathe him. Her hand shakes as she pours. What about the dismal paleographer? She laughs scornfully, but refuses to be drawn. I will not waste breath on the undeserving. Okay. The forlorn student of medieval manuscripts believes that the Emperor Charlemagne lies in the regent's grave. Speak to the dismal paleographer. His tent is some distance from the rest of the camp and almost in the forest. It is smaller and more worn than the tents of the others. Inside, however, the tent is both warm and sturdy. No rain leaks through the oilskin. The paleographer's inks and reference books and the old theater handbills are neatly sorted. The paleographer is at a little wooden desk, conjugating the subjunctive. Why do you think that the Holy Roman Empire Charlemagne is buried in a forgotten tomb in the high wilderness? It's a little strange, I admit. You certainly won't find any of this in Einhard, but there are legends that say the great king did not leave his people on death, and instead sleeps in a barrow, waiting for the hour of need. He almost smiles. You query his people. I do not forget that we are British. He pauses for effect. But is our queen not of German heritage? Would not her ancestor look out for her, Europe's greatest monarch, as she embarks on her most significant endeavor? What do you think about the feckless theologian? The paleographer is lost in thought. When he answers you, he looks rueful. The three of us were at college together in the same year. We were all interested in the theater, but eventually pursued other things. I hadn't seen him in years until the Traitor's Wood funding came up in the Senate. He sniffs. His intellect is second rate, but his charm is first class. Can't all be brilliant. He sighs despondently. What do you think about the vituperative classicist? A remarkable scholar and a terrifying goneril. At college, when she trod the boards, he shakes his head. Ancient history now. Which is her province, not mine. He makes a strong cup of tea for himself and then offers you the same. Bitterness has curdled her. He sips his drink, then grimaces, like his milk. Wonderful characters. Alright, so we can now do expeditions into the Traitor's Wood. In order to do so, we use up fuel and supplies, as well as certain amounts of crew. They can be extremely dangerous. We only have two supplies, so that would be quite... Actually, we can buy more. Oh-ho. Yes, yes, yes. So, it might actually be worth... Might actually be worth doing an expedition. They don't sell fuel here, though. So... Two fuel. We'll have enough to get back to at least Port Avon pretty easily, so we'll do a small expedition because I don't want to potentially murder my entire crew. Increase the chance of failure. Lower the chance of failure. You know what? Go big or go home. Let's do a large expedition. Okay. Hopefully our crew comes back, because if not, we're in trouble. A sizable contingent of your crew volunteers to follow you into the wood. Packs are hoisted onto the shoulders, rations divided and sensibly stored in little tubs. We're here with you, Captain, stout signaler tells you. Somerset College has, until recently, funded expeditions into the forest. Those who return speak of voices on the wind, of murmurs in uninhabited groves. So we need to decide what our destination is. Expeditions for outlandish artifacts are easier than for bronzewood. Occasionally, a quest will require you to choose a unique destination. If you leave while you have your crew embarked on an expedition, they will not be available until you complete that expedition. Okay. Well, we were tasked with trying to find the steward's font, so that is moderate difficulty. Let's do it. Let's go for the steward's font. The scholars share individually what they know. The transcriptions of the correspondence differ significantly, and they refuse to work together on a single translation. Still, it should be enough to get to the general area of the font. You gather your crew and make for the edge of the Whispering Wood. The scholars emerge from their tents to wave you off. You're on an expedition to the Steward's Font. far and farther into the woods you must go. You emerge into a field of purple flowers, bright new bruises. Captain, the stoker's voice is anxious. Can you hear them? Something whispers from beneath the petals. Listen to the voices. Stopper our ears. 69% chance of success? Oh, I can't not do that. Plug your ears somehow. Shut out the sound. No. 69. There's always one. One fool who unplugs their ears halfway across the field of whispering flowers that mutter in Latin and Sanskrit and Welsh. The last you see of him, he's racing across the field, stripping his sky suit as he goes. A search party turns up no trace of him. The flowers whisper on, unperturbed. We've lost a crew member. It begins to pour. The gray sky is angry. Your crew look desperate to make camp, and progress will be slow over sodden ground. Perhaps this is an opportunity to recover some of your strength. 52% chance. Yeah, let's rest. A navigator discovers a hollow way running through a vast copse of blackwood. You can set a watch at both ends and light a fire without being seen from elsewhere in the wood. Your crew stay up late, swapping stories of old rulers and their various ends. Your sleep is dreamless as death. Hey, sweet. Long shadows move through the silver trees ahead. There's a mournful howl. Someone sounds hungry, a stoker tries to joke. A low growling comes from behind you. The beasts have your scent. I am incredibly weak, so it is better for us to hide. You slip off the path into the depths of the wood where the great trees bend their boughs to conceal you. But in the traitor's wood, you are betrayed. A wind whips through the forest, brushing the canopy aside. You live to see your crew slaughtered. You do not stay to watch them be devoured. Their deaths have bought you a chance to flee. Welp. Hey, we found the steward's font. Below the thundering white water, a cave is visible, just under the lip of the rock. A scythe of starlight. You scale down the wet rock face and into the cave, and several moments before your eyes adjust to the light. The cavern is not natural. The walls are covered with bronzewood and studded with Navarrete gemstones, driven in too deep to remove. Distant starlight from the cave mouth reflects off the stones, filling the cave with radiance. Towards the back of the cave, you find a silver seal, the size of a crown and curved crescent blade. Correspondence is scored on the blade's battered metal. It is too large to move, but you record the sigils. Perhaps one of the scholars will be able to translate it. You take the seal. So, a successful expedition. We lost 3 crew members, which is, I mean, we were full up at 10, so that's not bad. We can live with that pretty easily. So, who do we talk to about this stuff? Let's talk to... Let's talk to the Dismal Paleoc. Actually... I'm very intrigued by the Sumerian Queen theory, so let's talk to the classicist and see what she has to say. She looks at you impatiently. Well, what did you find? She snatches the paper from your hands. A moment later, she laughs. It's a gift. An office of some kind. Ceremonial, no doubt. The kings of Sumeria gave out offices to their favorites, usually at religious observances. Just as their office came from the Queen of Heaven. And the rest. She pauses. She goes for pen and paper. By the time she's finished, she looks concerned. I've never heard of this particular office, the Tamer of the King's Bower. There's also reference to the Giggling Place and directions. I'll mark it on your map. Cool. All right, so that was our expedition. I'm guessing that now we can do an expedition to the Giggling Place, but we are not in a good place for that right now. So instead, we'll go to the Parting Glade. The forest rises behind the station where a few tents have been set up. What might be an owl calls from somewhere in the wood. In the far distance, a great stone barrow rises over the trees. The glade, an oasis of wildflowers and sweet meadow field in the midst of the brooding trees, is where the captains meet to do business and bring their ventures to the wood to conclusion. Let's write a port report. Outside of the Somerset camp, the great forest of bronzewood trees have gone untouched by human hands. Voices sound in the deeps of the woods, forlorn and far away. The wood is vast and vastly lonely. Let's explore the glade. There is no one here at present, but there are signs of recent passage. A discarded set of cups from some clandestine picnic, loose paper hastily torn from a notebook, a few bullets and scorched grass. People come to the glade to conduct meetings as neutral ground and as a place to think, secluded from the watchful gaze of the high wilderness. So that is the Traitor's Wood. We've got our bronze wood. I'm probably good to just get out of here. So, entering the Renan's Grave. Yeah, so now we can take an expedition to the Giggling Place, whatever that means. But we are low on supplies and low on fuel, and that is a little dangerous. So I think we go to Port Avon again. Resupply, maybe back up to New Winchester too. I might kind of go up around that way just to see what I can see. Might be able to find some points of interest, get some more experience. Everything at us. Is this a dead end? Yeah. It's just a marauder we can take in. Needed. They have like a spread gun. They'll wreck me if they get the chance. So I need to better. Faster than me too. All right. So much for that. We're dead. Oh, screw this game. That sucks. That just basically puts us back even further now. Okay. Cool. Thanks, game. Thanks for that. Wow, that's rough. That's two deaths in a single stream. Where do we start now? Let's see. Let's start as an academic. That was going to be my other choice if we didn't do poets. Do we want to do the practical sciences, the language of the heavens, or literature? I think literature is a good one. Once the most indulgent of studies, now the most seditious. The Ministry of Public Decency has gutted the libraries. We're an academic. I guess let's go with fame again, because we didn't really get that. We didn't get very far with our last attempt. Okay, new cap. We need someone that looks appropriately academic. Ooh. He looks pretty academic. Professor Edwards. I like it. Let's go, Professor Edwards. Okay, so we start at level 3 this time, instead of level 4. Let's... Disgraced predecessor. We'll do that one again. Your masterpiece. You would not let your education go to waste. You poured years of sleepless nights, setbacks, and research into one great work. They called you brilliant, eccentric, and obsessive. They said it was a waste of time. They said it was impossible. You proved them wrong. What were the fruits of your labor? A marvel of engineering, or a scathing critique of the new astronomy? Yeah, critique. And concealed within its 3 comprehensive and erudite volumes, which are approvingly stamped by the Ministry of Public Decency, is an encrypted but spirited call to revolution. Yeah. What's going on? New Winchester is in an uproar. Crowds of boisterous tackities stamp through the streets in their hobnail boots. In Kissigar Gardens, they are burning piles of top hats. The Windward Company, whose fortunes have suffered recently, has abandoned port. Ooh. They must have been preparing the evacuation for some time. Company House was emptied almost overnight. The tackities have the upper hand in the reach now, and the company has withdrawn much of its strength to fortify its holdings at Port Prosper. If you want to deal with the stovepipes, you'll need to seek them there. Okay, so the balance and power of the Reach has now changed, rather significantly. It will affect encounters, discoveries, bargains, and prospects in the Reach. For example, the Tackety's redoubled spirit means you'll encounter more homesteads while exploring. Cool. Okay, well, let's get the incautious driver again. And then seeds for Magdalene, nectar for Magdalene's as well. 3 gourds of chorister nectar. Sure, we can get those. We are pretty good on fuel and supplies. Whatever. Well, at least we know where the Somerset camp is now, in Traitor's Wood. So that's something. Chorister nectar. Where do I get that from? Is that from? Do I get that from Charon? No, I think I get that from Titania. So I wonder. I might just kind of like sneak up to Titania and then over to Magdalene's. Although, where do I get the seeds from? Magdalene's lies to the 3 sacks of verdant seeds. I don't remember where we get the seeds from. It might be Port Prosper. But for now, I guess let's go take a look at Titania. But first, let's check on the situation down in Victory Hall. Too different. Yeah, okay, so still the same, but the company house over here is probably going to be empty, because they said the stovepipes have abandoned it. The company house is abandoned. Reach is home to an ongoing struggle between London, via its proxy, the Windward Company, and those settlers who want independence. Let's inquire as to the fate of the prudent secretary. And, you suppose, the general manager, although the latter was rather less useful to than the former. Are the rumors true that they retreated to Port Prosper? Perhaps if the fortunes of the stovepipes improve and those of the Tacitus worsen, the company may be able to reclaim its old headquarters. For now, though, you'll need to do business with them at their smaller offices at Port Prosper, out on the margins of the Reach. Okay. So it's true. So now we're going to be seeing more Tacity scouts around. Instead of the other stovepipe ones, the blue locomotives. Go up. We have apparently had an effect on the things in the Reach, due to our constant delivering of port reports. Tacities instead of the stovepipes. I don't know. So apparently, if the Tacities have control of the Reach, you will encounter more homesteads, which makes sense because that's who they are. But I don't know what benefit you get if the stovepipes have control of the Reach. Fewer marauders, maybe? Did the expedition into the Traitor's Wood with our last captain. We now have to do that again with this captain. We start from square one, basically. Sniveling Spirifer selling souls. No thanks. I need the Chorister Nectar. Just one. Landing. That's right, a port report. Such a beauty. Such a pity about the nearby chorister hive. I think we did this stuff last time. Let's attend an art exhibition. Titania's largest petal hums with activity. The melancholy poet, rhapsodic mayor, and stone-faced sculptor have brought their best students together to showcase their work. They stand at a respectful distance, glaring at each other. You spend several pleasant hours surrounded by art, much of it painted with pigments sourced from the reach's unique flora and inspired by the lingering threat of chorister bees. Once the visitors have moved away, however, they immediately launch into lengthy diatribes on the many ways they could have done better. Well, alright. Let's explore Titania. Okay, that's the same thing that we had before. The porphyry font, a veiled pavilion, rests in the curve of one of Titania's great petals. Melancholy poet will also arrange for a well-paying artist to enjoy the presence of a muse. 300 sovereign and 250 experience for this moment of inspiration. Ooh. Wow, that is kind of hard to pass up. I don't like giving up something like that because I'm pretty sure these are pretty rare, but that's also a lot of money. And we had a pretty major setback this stream, so I think I'm going to do that. I'll keep my vision of the heavens, though, because I got two of those. I inherited those from the last captain. And then... Okay, so at this point, Port Prosper still needs a... We've got the Chorister Nectar. They need Bronzewood as well. Actually, what else? Oh, they need 3 Chorister Nectar for Magdalene's. I might do that one, actually. So we can just afford that. Yeah, we'll do that. Then I'll kind of zip on over to Magdalene's there. And we should be good. I wonder what it would be like to live on a giant flower. Probably not too bad, as long as you could live with the constant looming threat of giant bees. Gunshots. I haven't activated my chief engineer. Can I not? Huh. Maybe I have to be in port. Whatever's going on down there, I don't want to be a part of it. We don't have a drill and we don't have our canning equipment anymore, so... Whatever that bounty is, we can't get it. Not yet, anyway. I'm definitely getting a drill. That's happening. Let's go to the circus. and get some more court reports. Okay. New arrivals at the circus. Fire burns by the obelisk where newcomers make them. None of them seem to know what drew them there, or what drew them here, save that they had nowhere else they knew they should be. They trade stories and the last of the liquor from their flasks, finding solace here for reasons they can't seem to explain. Listen to their stories. Who were they before they were called here? The broken, the disavowed, the fugitives. Every visitor has their own story and a hole in their heart. A few demonstrate acts which they hope to join the circus itself. Others talk of plans to leave this place and resume their lives. Not today, but tomorrow. Or the day after that, perhaps. The amiable vagabond. We don't have two sky stories. Sorry. He wants nothing to do with us. There we go. Get our chief engineer. The inconceivable circus. Write a port report. Alright, so we've been here before. We were here last time. We could... How much do tickets cost? $10. Let's do it. Got 5 tickets to the circus. Let's go to the big top. Yeah, we've seen this already. It's all the same acts. Humiliated magician, the bereaved acrobat, and the pensive clown. Problem clown. Let's go to the amusements. Yeah, I think we've seen this already. So they are... 3. Is it the ticket booth? No. Can we get into the back? We are not well known enough in the circus. Oh well. Purveyor of fine scouts. We don't have enough money to buy a scout. And we only have one sky story, so we can't get the amiable vagabond. Alas. Oh, they're selling bronzewood here. For a lot of money. Wow. I can't afford that. Also, barrels of unseasoned hours. If I needed those, I would sure get some. But I don't. Those deals change every 30 days. So if you do make a mental note of where certain deals are, you can always head back and get them before they run out. We'll take the path up and around the Magdalens. Deliver this chorister nectar. From the terrifying bees of Titania. It is kind of the unfortunate part of the game, just having to start over again with a new captain. You kind of need to get yourself reestablished. Oh, hold on. A wreckage of the Han. What do we got? 49% chance of success. Enter through the yawning tear in the hull. Let's do it. Not all of them make it. Yeah. We've done this before. We lost a crew, but we did get a Tale of Terror, so that's kind of cool. And 69 sovereigns. Oh. I'm just gonna leave. I don't know what that is. I've never seen that before. Oh, he's faster than me. I'm gonna die again. With this game. Yep, dead again. Oh man, this game just basically dropped me back down to square one. We went from a level 5 captain to a level 2 captain. Oh god. And it's, like, I'm not even doing things that are difficult. Like, it's just random chance. I keep running into things that are just faster and stronger than me, and multiple of them, and so they just murder me. Well, we have not yet played a character with high veils. We've done Iron Hearts and Mirrors. Although the hearts and mirrors were extremely short-lived. So, screw it. Let's be a revolutionary. The world is broken. One way for the rich, another for the poor. We've decided to do something about it. The engines were the state. The engines of the state were set against that which you knew to be just. With your feet and fists, you marched, and when marching wasn't enough, we fought. And we're here to get rich. Yeah, that looks like a revolutionary. What should our name be? Probably not My Lord. That is not a very revolutionary name. Sing. Sir Covington. Bell is a pretty good last name, and I definitely know what title we want to go with. There we go. We are the revolutionary Comrade Bell. Alright, so we only get one of these moments of reflection. Let's go with a disgraced predecessor. This time to villains. Alright. Let's get the incautious driver. We really don't have a whole lot of money. Seeds for Magdalene. Pensive Devil at Carolyn will pay 150 sovereigns each for up to 5 barrels of unseasoned hours. Ooh. Yeah. Don't mind if I do. And there's nothing in storage because we didn't have anything to store anyway. Oh, boy. Okay. So I wonder, they're going to have different deals, so Polmer and Plenty's probably won't have unseasoned hours for sale. But I wonder if I should just do the same. We'll go up there. We'll go to the circus and see what they've got for sale. If nothing else, at this point I don't have enough money to really buy anything anyway, so I'm pretty much just gonna have to write court reports and then make it back to having wealth. Might have to do some off-screen grinding, get my get some money for us to play with, because this was a rather significant setback, or rather setbacks. At least the nice thing about this game is, even if you die, it's all part of the same legacy, so some things carry on. So the Tacitys still have influence in the Reach. That won't really change until we start. If we start turning in port reports to the stovepipes, then the balance of power will change. Came in a little hot, that one. All right, let's write a port report. Let's go to the circus again. We'll go to the big top. Yeah, everything's all the same. Visit the amusements. All the same. And we are not recognizable enough to do anything else. We only have one sky story, so... Oh, sacks of verdant seeds for only 25 bucks? Oh, God. I might actually be able to do that. How many do they need? 3 sacks of verdant seeds, 80 sovereigns for each one. So if I sell... Hang on, is this worth it? If I sell 2 supplies, I'll have enough to get 3 sacks of seeds, which will get me 240 sovereigns, and I'll have to spend 80. You know what, I'm not gonna sell anything, I'm just going to buy 2 of these. Got no money, but we can go to Magdalene's and hopefully not get eaten by some sort of eldritch abomination like last time. That was legitimately the first time I've ever seen that enemy pop up in a game before. I've never seen the tentacle train in all the time that I have played this game. That's my first encounter with one. I was not impressed. Michelin's Meadow. I don't think I've been up there before. But I don't want to risk it, so we're just going to ride the wind down to Magdalene's.
is over here.
I feel like the wind wasn't here last time. Maybe the location of the wind changes. Oh, maybe it was. I can't remember. Anyway. We return to Magdalene's. Magdalene's house is small comfort. Write a port report. Thank you. Let's try to talk to the amenable host again. Well, in the meantime, let's get rid of these seeds. Get us money. Oh, they're selling bronzewood here. Interesting. The keepsake market. We don't need crew. We don't need to produce our terror. Don't have any nightmares. Guess let's speak with an attendant. Yeah, we've done this before. We have to become a gnome. I guess we could treat our terror. I only have one vision of the heavens. I don't want to give it up just yet. Yeah, it's probably not worth doing that. We do need to get hours for Caravan, so I might go down to Port Prosper. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna have to do some off-screen work just to try and get some of our lost fortune back. Just doing busy work, going around, going to port report, turning in port reports, and doing some trading and whatnot. Just basic stuff. I've taken a silly direction. But potentially a bit safer than the other option. With the way that this game has been going tonight. One stream of sunless skies and four captains later, we have accomplished basically nothing. Oh. That is a homestead. Hello. Here is an abandoned homestead. Its roof sagged, its windows empty of glass. For every settler that makes a life for themselves in the Reach, another is lost. 30% chance of success. Let's get out of here. No one who lives in the wild is likely to welcome strangers. Hello. And tank. These things are kind of easy to fight. They just charge at you. They don't have any ranged attacks. Just quick. Oh. I think they're weaker than most locomotives, too. These ones are. See, if I still had our canning material, then we'd be able to make supplies out of this thing. But unfortunately, I bought my canning material and then literally never ran into those things again. So, oh well. Let's get these precious stones or fail. We lost a crew member and gained 11 bucks. Whatever. It's a small price to pay for revolution. Or something. I don't know. Let's just get to Port Prosper. Get to Port Prosper and end this cursed run. Please don't crash into me. So I myself do not have any standing between the Tachetes and Stovepipes. If I had more standing with the Tachetes, they would probably try to attack me. These guys with the Stovepipes. But I don't want that. Because they've got very powerful trains. Now, are you? Let's explore. Right a port. Attend a parade. It's apparently the Feast of the Red Saint. Sure. I think we did this one already. And go with the EastEnders lurking in the tents or manning the solid side streets scowling at the passing gentry. Yeah. Oi, a wide-eyed EastEnder elbows his comrade somewhere under his jacket. Who's all this then? The crowd gathers from the shadows. You're subjected to a number of looks that, if not quite filthy, are at least grubby. Eventually, the huddle disperses. The first EastEnder extends a thin hand, lined and worn. It's a good sign you wanted to talk to us. You spend the afternoon watching the vaudeville players satirize the Red Saint and his dragon in an out-of-the-way tent, followed by a hearty supper of roast chestnuts and almost palatable ale down by the station. All right. Transport to settlers. Yeah, let's do it. I'd appreciate it if you took me to Traitor's Wood. I'm in the mood for a spot of sport. Okay. We can do that. We know where that is. We can recruit the Incognito Princess. Yeah. Let's get her. We don't actually have to pay 100 sovereigns. She just wants to know that we have that much money. Other company house. After the company's fortunes declined in New Winchester, they withdrew to Port Prosper, where the parsimonious chairman received them with barely concealed distaste. So now the company house is over in Port Prosper, and we can do things for them here. Oh, more seeds. Oh, I can get more seeds for Magdalene's. Perfect. I can finish that one. Let's do that. Get some more supplies, fuel. They're also selling unseasoned hours here, which we need for Carolyn. How much were they willing to pay? 150 sovereigns each. So if I spend 80 here, that is a profit of 70 sovereigns a barrel. I can't actually afford that. Oh well. We've got the verdant seeds, so we can finish that. For the time being, let's equip our first officer. Okay, so I guess we still know that we need the chorister nectar and bronzewood, as one would expect. Everything here is pretty much the same. Thank you. last time. I think that is probably going to have to do me for tonight. Like I said, I'll probably do some grinding off screen just to kind of get our funds back to a reasonable level. Maybe buy some of the supplies back that we lost. I've got a pretty good kick in the nuts this stream about 3 times from this game, but that's kind of the nature of the RNG, I guess. We got some unlucky rolls and ended up where we are. But we got a brand new captain again and again and again, who is a revolutionary, good old Comrade Bell. And we got a long way to go from here. But until next time, that will have to be it for this brief adventure. We'll get back to this. I guess it won't be next Sunday. Next Sunday, there will be something different going on that there will be more information about coming in the week. I will be taking part in some of it, but there will be a whole bunch of stuff going on next Sunday. It's going to be pretty cool. I know Action Shakespeare will have more information on her channel, most likely, probably on her Twitter, so check that out if you're interested. It's going to be fun. It's going to be a good time. She's also streaming tomorrow evening, so if you're interested in checking that out, it's worth checking in tomorrow. I will be back this Tuesday I still need to do some testing, but if everything works out, I'm going to have something interesting. It may not be the most original thing in the world, but I'm super excited for it, and I'm excited. So I'll do some testing, and I will be back on Tuesday with something different. I'll be dropping more information on that probably tomorrow on Twitter, so follow me there if you aren't already. Other than that, B-Drops is currently doing Art Soup, I believe, so I am going to raid them, and we will call that an evening. Let me just do that. Raid A drops. Yeah. So we will join into that, and I will see everyone on Tuesday for sure, and then Sunday more than likely somewhere else. But I will retweet and post more information on that later. So keep tuned in to find out what's going on, and I will see everyone later. Please have a good night, and thank you for joining me on this cursed adventure.